I've been using Windows 11 as my main operating system for about a month now, and I've been using my unattended WinStall version of Windows 11. And although I find it much better to use Windows 11 without all of the bloatware and unnecessary stuff running in the background, there are still some things I don't like about Windows 11, and that is the taskbar, start menu, and right-click menu. Now the good news is there are a lot of programs that you can use to replace the shell in Windows 11, and that's what the next few videos are going to be about on my channel. If you want to check out the other videos, go ahead and look at the description of this video, and I'll have all of those videos linked in a playlist that you can go ahead and watch. Now in this video, we're going to be having a look at TranslucentTB, which is basically used to make the taskbar translucent or transparent in Windows 11. So on Windows 10, you can just do this with some simple registry entries, but on Windows 11, that's no longer possible, and you need to use a program like TranslucentTB to make the taskbar transparent in Windows 11. Now, I've also made another video on this channel where I showed you how to make the taskbar transparent with Windhawk, which is a software that you can use to mod Windows 11. And I'll leave a link to that video in the description down below, as well as the playlist where I show you how to replace the shell in Windows 11 with a bunch of free programs. So you can go ahead and look at that if you're interested. But in this video, I'm going to download TranslucentTB and install it on this version of Windows 11. And it's pretty funny that start is spelled that way. But let's strat the download. And that's going to download an MSIX bundle package where you can then click on open file. Then you'll have this option to install TranslucentTB. Now you can also get this from the Microsoft Store directly. I'm just downloading it directly from their website, but I'm just going to go ahead and click on install. And it's also going to launch it automatically. Now, if we have a look at this welcome screen here, you can donate to these developers, or you can join their Discord server, or you can edit the configuration file. But for now, let's just click on continue. And as you can see, TranslucentTB lives in the system tray. So we're going to get to those settings now. But you can see that the taskbar is already completely transparent. Even if you open the start menu, the taskbar still stays completely transparent. So if I go ahead and show the hidden icons in the system tray here, we'll find TranslucentTB. And if I click on that, it's going to give me some other options here. So if we have a look at this first tab here, which is the desktop tab, we can show the taskbar border, which basically gives us this line here. And I definitely don't want to show that. I'm going to hide that. If we go back to the settings, we can choose more options here. So if I set this to opaque, it basically turns it completely black, if that's something you want to use. Clear, we've already seen. And then acrylic is basically this taskbar, which is kind of see-through, but it's blurred, if you want to call it that. Let's leave it on clear, so it's completely transparent. So obviously, you have some other options in TranslucentTB here. And I'm not going to be going through each of them in this video here. One of the settings you can just have a look at is if it should open at boot, which basically means every time you start up your computer, TranslucentTB should launch automatically. So it basically turns the taskbar transparent without you having to do anything. Something I want to have a look at is if I can use OpenShell to make the start menu transparent as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and download OpenShell from the GitHub page here. And I've used OpenShell a few times in the previous videos in this playlist as well, where I basically replaced the shell of Windows 11, like I mentioned earlier. So I'm not going to be going through step by step in this video. You can go ahead and watch those videos if you're interested in seeing OpenShell, but it's basically just a start menu replacement where you can get older versions of the start menu in previous versions of Windows on Windows 11. So I normally have it set to this Windows 7 style, but if we right click on the start button and then select settings, that's going to take us to the OpenShell menu settings. And right now I've got the Windows arrow skin selected. So one of these options here is to reduce the glass color, and I want to see what that looks like. So that basically just turned the start menu black or gray. I'm not sure if there is a skin that'll cause the start menu to be completely transparent. We have some transparency settings here in the immersive skin. So if I go ahead and select that, it's definitely not translucent. If we set that to full glass, it's definitely not transparent either. If we go to show all settings and we have a look at the menu look, if we scroll down, I have this option to override the glass color. And if I set that to white and then reduce the glass opacity to zero, I'm interested to see what that looks like. And that basically just gives us a gray start menu. So unfortunately, it doesn't look like OpenShell can give me a fully transparent start menu, but I'll just leave Windows arrow selected. And I guess it does have some sort of see-through element on the right here. And like I mentioned before, I can also use Windhawk and use the start menu styler in Windhawk to get a transparent start menu. And I'm actually going to go ahead and have a look at that. I'm actually going to have a look at downloading Windhawk in this video as well, just so we can see what it looks like with the TranslucentTB application installed. And like I mentioned before, I already have a dedicated video made specifically for Windhawk. And there is a mod in there that also turns the taskbar transparent. But I just want to have a look and see if TranslucentTB works with Windhawk, and specifically the start menu styler that Windhawk has. So I'm just going to run Windhawk. Then the mod I'm looking for is the Windows 11 start menu styler. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that and then install it. Then I'm just going to go to settings, and the theme I'm going to be selecting is the Translucent start menu. And then I'm going to save these settings. So now if we open the start menu, we have a translucent start menu with the transparent taskbar. But the thing is, the taskbar is completely transparent and the start menu still has this sort of blur look to it. So it's not completely transparent or translucent like the taskbar is. And if I go ahead and I exit TranslucentTB so that I have the normal Windows 11 taskbar, and I go ahead and install the taskbar styler mod, and then I'm going to select the translucent taskbar theme and save that. You can see it does not do the same thing as the actual TranslucentTB application, and it just makes the taskbar and start menu have a translucent look, but it's not completely clear. In my opinion, I think this is more of an acrylic look. If we go ahead and we launch Translucent Taskbar again, TranslucentTB, and it seems I need to restart the computer before I can use it. So let's just go ahead and do that. As you can see, the TranslucentTB taskbar is completely clear and completely see-through. If I switch it to acrylic, this basically resembles the translucent taskbar that Windhawk has as a theme. So TranslucentTB with the clear theme gives you a completely transparent taskbar, and even if you take Windows and you put it behind the taskbar, you can still see what's inside of those windows as well. And it is the best app on Windows 11 to get a transparent taskbar or a completely see-through taskbar. I would have liked if OpenShell had some sort of completely transparent taskbar as well, but using OpenShell with TranslucentTB is also fine. And if you wanted to use TranslucentTB in conjunction with Windhawk and then have the translucent start menu, which looks like this, where the recommended section is also removed, you can go ahead and do that. And this is basically what your Windows 11 installation would look like. But I'm still going to use start all back on my computer because it just works the best in my opinion. But I hope you found some sort of value in this video. If you did, please give it a like. And if you want to support this channel, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.